Hello friends, Shashank this side. I hope you all are doing well today. So today we'll be going to learn about an interesting topic provided by Amazon, which is auto-scaling. So first of all, we're going to have a look on the theoretical side of the house, followed by a practical demo to understand the configuration. Again, this video is dedicated to the configuration of an auto-scaling, how auto-scaling works in terms of load, when the load increases, how it spins up the instance. The next video which is coming up is with load balancing, because auto-scaling works best in conjunction with your elastic load balancer from Amazon. So let's try and understand how auto-scaling works. So Amazon EC2 auto-scaling help us to ensure that we should have a correct number of EC2 instances available to handle the load of your application. What does this mean? So whenever load of your application increases, auto-scaling will gonna help us to spin up another instance with the same configuration just to handle the load. In same way, it can go up to one to number of instances that you provide. Okay. AWS Auto-scaling also monitors your application and automatically adjusts the capacity to maintain the steady, predictable and performance at lowest preferable cost. Okay. It also helps us to maintain the cost as well. So let's say you have a application and you don't want to spend a lot of cost on it, but you want to have a best performance with all the load balancing concept come into picture, then you can use auto scaling where it will gonna handle the load of your application by spinning or up or spinning down the number of instances. So in that way, the costing will always be in a preferable criteria. Using auto scaling, it's easy to set up application scaling for multiple resources across multiple services in minutes. So this is as simple as that. You don't have to do anything manual. So let's say you have provisioned an application today with one server, and in near future, what you're observing that your load to that application is getting increased. Then if you have auto scaling configuration in picture, then it will gonna handle that request and spin up another instance with the same configuration at same time, and it will gonna balance the load with the help of load balancer. AWS auto scaling makes scaling simple with recommendations that allow you to optimize performance, cost or balance between them. Again, the same thing, like it helps us to manage the cost, it helps us to manage the load, it helps us to optimize the performance as well. So this diagram I have taken from Amazon website, where we have certain terms, like with the auto scaling group, what are the things we need to configure? Minimum size, desired capacity, maximum size, scale out as needed. So for example, let's try and understand these terms actually. So let's say we have an application, again, .NET or Node.js, on AWS. So to run an application, we need at least one server or one EC2 instance. So with the term minimum size, it means we need at least one server to host an application. Okay. During the load time, when let's say CPU or memory goes beyond 90%, then based upon that particular criteria, scale out the instance with the same configuration. So that is something the scale out as needed means. The same way you can scale down when your threshold is coming down less than 50%. So the next one is desired capacity. So desired capacity is like at any point of time, I want to run 10 instances across all the environment, right? So that is something you need to have desired number of capacity of running instances. The maximum is like scale up, like number of 4, 5, 6 instances, and it can go up to 100 as per the configuration. So you can go to the maximum level of your instances while scaling up your environment. So that's what these terms are all about. And this is something required when you gonna configure auto scaling. Okay. So the next one is like the components that we gonna use with the auto scaling. One of the most important is the launch configuration. This is acting like a template where you're gonna select the AMI, whether it is from Amazon or it's your own custom AMI. Then you have to select the instance type, storage, security groups, and the key pair. The next component that auto-scaling uses is auto-scaling group. We have to create a group where we'll be using launch configuration, that what we have created above. Then we're gonna select the networks, the subnets like VPCs and subnets. Again, if you're not aware of VPCs and subnet, there is a video series on AWS network section on my channel. Please watch that to get a clear understanding. Scaling up policies to increase the number of servers, scaling down policies to decrease the number of servers, then monitoring and the alarm. So based upon the alarms, like let's say we have designed after 90% of the CPU usage, spin up one more instance. After like 50% or less than 50% of the CPU usage, just spin down that particular instance and keep the minimum number of instances that we have designed or opted for. So these two are the components which are like very important to design auto scaling group. So I hope this clears a lot about what auto scaling is all about, where we can use this configuration and where this is useful. Again, this particular video is totally dedicated to the configuration of an auto scaling. Next video is like I'm gonna use load balancer in conjunction with my auto scaling configuration. So let's jump to our AWS management console and do the practical demo. So this is my AWS management console. You can see I have logged in with my user. So to go to the auto scaling group, we have to go to compute and EC2. Okay, on the left hand side, if you scroll down at the bottom, you will gonna see auto scaling. So we have two options, launch configuration and auto scaling group. So if you go to auto scaling group and if you try to create auto scaling group, this will ask you to create a configuration. So create or select a launch configuration and then create an auto scaling group. Okay, so let's cancel this and go to launch configuration and try to create our launch configuration. So you can see like save up to 90% on compute. Optimize compute cost by creating your auto scaling group with a launch template to combine EC2 on demand, spot and reserve instances. So this is very helpful in terms of the costing purpose, in terms of the optimization performance. It's very good. So create launch configuration. I already have an AMI, so either you can select or any one of your choice. So this will gonna give you the OS platform only, but what I'll gonna do, I have an AMI called Auto-scaling Apache. So this AMI is consisting of an Apache installed on it. So I'm gonna select that. And I'll be going with T2 Micro, the free version, configure detail. So let's say Auto-scaling Apache. The naming convention can be anything, okay? I'll be keeping everything as default. You can select for spot instances as well. You can select any of the role. For example, if you want to access your S3 bucket with your EC2 instance, then you can select this role or any kind of permission that you have designed. If you go to advanced detail, these are the kernel ID, RAM ID. So again, this can be selected as per your requirement. So I'm keeping it as default. This totally depends upon you. If you want to execute some kind of script, the shell script during the boot process, you can do that. Add storage. I'll be going with 8 gigs. Security group. So I already have a security group where I'm opening port 22 and port 80. Review. Create a launch configuration. Select your key pair and create launch configuration. So my launch configuration is created. This will gonna spin up, my launch configuration is created. Using this launch configuration, we'll gonna create our auto scaling group. So let's click on this and give this name as, generally auto scaling is, the terminology that we use is ASG. So let's give this name as ASG. Now, group size, this is quite important. So let's take an example. We have to make sure that it's set to the correct size, as during the launch, this will gonna launch the number of instances. So if you select this as 10, this will gonna spin up 10 instances. So again, I'm just going for one. This is the VPC. So I don't have any custom VPC. So this can be created in custom VPC as well. So I'll be going with default subnets. So you can select any number of subnets. So for example, if you're using this with your load balancers, then obviously we're gonna select or two different availability zone just to make sure our application is in high availability zone. So I'm gonna select two for now. I don't want to create number of instances. So create policies. Let's use this one. So I just want to go up to four. So scale between one and four instances. This will be the minimum and the maximum number in your group. So minimum, there will be one instance, and maximum, it can go up to four. Okay, so here we define the policies. Increase the group size. So this is for the incremental instance. So let's say, let's keep it as default. We have to select an alarm. So let's create an alarm where, so this is my email ID, test email ID basically. So let's say when CPU utilization is going more than 50%. So for at least one consecutive period of 5 minutes, till that time, this will gonna monitor it. Then it will gonna throw us an alarm like it's going beyond 50% on the CPU side. The action that I want to do, it's add an instance like one in the capacity unit. So whenever CPU utilization is going beyond 50%, add one more instance to my group. Instance needed. So this is the warm up after each step. So by default, it is 300 seconds. So we're gonna keep that. That's the standard that we have across the industry standard. Now decrease. Obviously, I don't want to consist because I don't know like when my load will gonna increase, right? So based upon that, this will gonna scale up my number of instance. But, and again, it will gonna add one by one by one, and it will go till four, okay? Because that is the maximum number that we have. Okay, so the next one is like decrease. Again, let's create an alarm. When my CPU is going less than, let's say 20%, remove at least for one consecutive period of 5 minutes, create an alarm and remove one more instance. So this will gonna add one instance, this will go to four, this will gonna remove one instance one by one when it is going below 20%. And again, the minimum number that it will gonna contain is one. At least we're gonna have one instance running all the time. Okay, so this is the policy that we have. This is for increment, this is for decrement. So let's create a notification, add notification. So whenever instance launch, terminate, fail to launch, fail to terminate, send me the notification. Configure the tag, naming, let's say ASG web server. Review and create your auto scaling group. As simple as that. Now this, what this will gonna do, this will gonna spin up my one instance having that Apache. So let's close it and let's go to our instances. Okay, so this is my ASG web server that it's creating. So just wanted to show the image that I have created, the AMI. I have used this server to create an AMI. So if you're not aware of how to create an AMI, I'll be sharing a link at the top. So just go through that. That will give you a clearer picture how to create an AMI. So let's open up a new interface and this is the test page. So we're gonna see this page once this server is up. Okay, so this is the public IP. Let's try because it's in initialization phase. So let's try to hit this. Here we go, 7229. 7229 and we are getting test page. So our Apache is up and running now. Okay, so if you go to our auto-scaling group, let's see what are the options that we can see from here. So you can see the details. It's loading up. Okay. You can see the launch configuration that it has used. What are the subnets that we have selected? Health check is EC2. Then the health check grace period is 300 seconds. If we go over here, the activity history, this is successful on the launch side. Scaling policies. So step scaling, this is decrease, like less than 20%, remove the instance. And if more than 50%, then it will gonna increase one more instance. Instances you can see from here, it's healthy. It's in availability zone 1C. Monitoring, by default, we get these things in terms of the monitoring, like minimum group size, maximum desired capacity, what are the services are, what are the instances are in services, then pending, standby. These are the things that we are getting with monitoring notification. This will gonna check all these and send out a notification. Tags, you can do a schedule action as well over here. Then we have a life cycle. You can create a life cycle hook as well for this. So I'm gonna create another video that is dedicated to the life cycle of auto scaling. Okay, so let's go back to our instance and try to log in. So this is the new server. Let's copy this. Okay, clear and exit. Process can, let's terminate and open a new one. Let me maximize this a bit for better view. CD downloads SSH-I, then we have key pair EC2-user at instance. Case I want to connect. Okay, let's clear this. Let's see, with the help of top, we can see like the CPU percentage is idle 100. Okay, so no activity is happening over here. Now, to make our auto scaling work as per our expectation, because the policy that we have set to create another instance is 50% and greater than that of CPU. So for that, what I'll gonna do, cancel. I'll gonna use this command just to increase CPU to 100%. So let me run this as root sudo. Here we go. Now let's try to use top. Now you can see CPU percentage is going to 96. Okay. Previously it was 100 as an ideal state. Now it's taking, this particular process is taking 100, almost 100% of CPU. So let's try and check if our auto scaling group or the configuration that we have done is working or not. This will gonna take like, because the cooling time is somewhere around 300 seconds. So this will gonna, as you can see, the cooling period is, cool down period is 300 seconds. So this will gonna take some time to spin up another instance. So let's go to our instance section. So we are just waiting for another instance. As you can see, we have another instance coming up with T2 Micro, the same size that we have for our this one, ASG web server. So it has taken the same tag name because the configuration that we have done is almost same. So I'm gonna show you, once this server is up, I'm gonna show you that this will gonna show you the same page that we have configured for 7229 server. Okay, again, this will gonna take a few seconds to come up. So this took almost like 5 minutes, because if you remember the CloudWatch alarm that we have configured, one data point will gonna check for 5 minutes, and after 5 minutes, if it still continues to have 99% or more than 50% of CPU, then this will gonna spin up another instance in our auto-scaling group. So that's what it's doing as of now. So again, if you go to our auto-scaling group, activity history, not yet in service, it's still spinning up. If you go to the instances, you can see it's still spinning up. It's in the pending state. Okay, so let's go to our instances. So this will gonna take like a minute or so. Meanwhile, we're gonna wait. I'll gonna have this video pause. Once this is in available state, I'll show you, and I'll gonna terminate this particular process just to show you that it will gonna spin down or remove one of the instance which is in service. Okay. So our instance is up and running. As you can see, there is another instance is coming up. So let me gonna grab the IP address, and you can see 7229 was the first server that showed the Apache page. If we browse this one, let's browse this. So 184.242, it's showing the same Apache page. That means our configuration has been worked, because if I show you the CPU usage, it's still showing 99.7. which is, as per our configuration, anything above 50 will gonna spin up an instance, and within that duration it will go up to 4 instances max. Okay, now let's try to kill. So kill all, and if we go to here, let's try to kill this process and hit top. Now you can see the idle percentage has been changed to 100 now. So sooner one of the instances will gonna get shut down. So as you can see, our servers are getting terminated because the threshold that we have set, less than 20%, only one instance will be in the running state. So you can see the idle percentage for CPU is 100 on the running instance. So the two of the instances has been, one is already terminated, another is in shutdown state. So this is the way how auto-scaling group configuration works. And this works best when you use with AWS load balancer. So next video, as I said, coming up with AWS load balancer plus auto-scaling, where we're gonna see like how this works in terms of the load balancing scenario. Again, if you want to update your configuration, so you can go to the launch configuration. So let's say if you have updated your AMI, or you have updated the patches and everything to the AMI, what you can do, select the launch template that you have created, actions, copy the launch. So this will gonna open up a review page, the launch configuration review page. What you have to do, you have to go to the choose AMI, the first step. You have to select the latest AMI ID over here. And if you want to update any of the settings over here, you can do that. In that way, you can create your auto scaling launch configuration template. Again, this is very important and this is very useful because it helps us to do a lot of cost saving. So just try it out on your account. Try to create a launch configuration from that. Use auto scaling group to create your servers, and try to increase your memory or CPU load with the script I have used. I'll gonna share that in my description section, and just check it out whether everything is working fine or not, whether it is scaling up your instance or not and scaling down your instance or not. If you have any concern, just place out a comment in comment section and I'll be there to help you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.